The HINTS examination, an acronym for head impulse, nystagmus, and test of skew, is a cluster of three bedside tests used to evaluate a patient with acute onset dizziness that is continuously present, even when still. These tests can quickly differentiate between an inner ear vestibular problem versus central vertigo, which may be due to a stroke. The head impulse test starts by flexing the patient's head down slightly and moving their head slowly back and forth while having their eyes maintain fixed focus straight ahead. The head is then moved quickly and unexpectedly to one side while the patient tries to maintain straight target focus. The test is considered normal if the eyes stay focused on target without slippage. However, if the eyes are dragged off the straight-ahead target, even briefly, the test would be considered abnormal. An abnormal test to the right looks something like this, which suggests some type of right inner ear balance system weakness. An abnormal test to the left looks like this. Please note that there needs to be a minimum 50% weakness of the inner ear vestibular system in order for this test to be positive. Next, check the patient's eyes for any nystagmus, which are involuntary repetitive eye twitching. To evaluate for nystagmus, have the patient move the eyes in all the cardinal directions: left, right, up, and down. Normally, nystagmus should be absent. However, if nystagmus is present, note which direction the eye is beating towards. The direction of nystagmus is defined by the direction of the quick phase. For example, in this video clip, the fast phase of the nystagmus is to the left. Here it is in slow motion. An inner ear or vestibular cause for dizziness is suggested if the nystagmus is horizontal and the direction remains the same, regardless of which direction the eye is looking. Note how the nystagmus speeds up when looking in the same direction as the nystagmus. A neurologic cause for dizziness is suggested if the nystagmus changes direction with eye movement. Neurologic cause for dizziness is also suggested if vertical or torsional nystagmus is present in any eye position. The skew test, also known as the cover test, involves the patient focusing straight on a target while the clinician covers and uncovers each eye, observing for any vertical movement of the uncovered eye. Normally, the uncovered eye remains steady. However, if it moves up or down, this indicates a vertical skew deviation, which can suggest a serious brain disorder involving the brainstem or cerebellum instead of a more benign cause due to an inner ear vestibular problem. Collectively, when all three HINTS exams are performed in a dizzy patient, it is 95% accurate in identifying a central cause like stroke or peripheral origin like labyrinthitis. Accuracy is further increased when performing a HINTS plus test when adding a fourth sign, which is the presence of a one-sided new onset hearing loss.